AJ with AJ Mobile Money. Thanks for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. You know what to do. If you're not a subscriber, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Hit that like button because you're going to like this video. And also hit the notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. So I've had a few people ask me about the Amazon credit card, the credit builder card that was recently announced by Amazon. So I'm just going to take a few minutes to talk about that specific card and a little bit about secured credit cards. So this month, Amazon introduced the Amazon Credit Builder Secured Credit Card. And what this is, what secured credit cards are basically cards where you provide a deposit that could be anywhere from $100 up to $1,000. And that deposit is used as collateral for the credit card. So if a traditional credit card, which is called an unsecured credit card, what they do is they provide you with credit to make purchases, and there is no collateral that they use for that card. So if your normal Amazon store credit card, it is an unsecured card, you have to apply for it, and then based on your credit report, based on your credit score, they will allow you to have a certain limit that they'll allow you to make purchases. Now with the credit builder, because it's geared towards people that have either no credit or they have bad credit. So what they'll do is give you a limit. That limit could be as little as $100. And with that $100, you make a deposit to Amazon, and then that allows you to use their credit card to help build your credit when you make purchases on Amazon. Now, in order to upgrade to the normal Amazon store credit card, what you have to do is make purchases and make those payments on time for a minimum of 7 months. So Amazon has a partnership with Synchrony Bank, who is actually the provider of the credit card, and they will determine based on your credit score, based on your other credit history, based on any delinquencies, based on how you're paying your bills overall, not just with that specific card. After 7 months, you will then be eligible to potentially upgrade to the normal store card. So let's talk about some of the features of this card. As far as the interest rate, it is very high. And obviously, this is for an obvious reason. It's because it's for people that have bad credit or who have no credit. So you don't have that trust in their purchase history, or more specifically, their payment history to show that they're going to actually pay off the credit card. And so because of that, when you have bad credit, there's typically higher interest rates. And so this Amazon card specifically is a 20% interest rate for that card. Now, another feature of this card is that you get 5% cash back for all of your purchases at Amazon. Now, this is for any purchases for items under $149. If it is something that's over $149, then you have an additional feature that you're eligible for. So for items over $149, you can choose to either have 5% cash back, or you can choose their promotional financing. So this means that you may have a certain period of time, which could be months, it could be a year, to pay off the item that you purchased through Amazon. Now, this is only available for products or purchases that you make that are over $149. Now, since this is a secured card, it is meant to help you with improving your credit by showing good payment history over a certain amount of time, and then you can upgrade to the Amazon store card. Now, the minimum requirements in order to upgrade would be to make on-time payments for a minimum of 7 months in a row, and then that will make you eligible for Synchrony Bank to then make a decision based on your other payment history, not just with this card, but with any other credit cards that you have, any other debts that you have. And if you have any bankruptcies or delinquencies, then you won't be eligible to actually upgrade to the normal store credit card, which would put you into an unsecured credit card. Now, 7 months is just the minimum. It doesn't mean that everyone that has that card for 7 months and makes on-time payments will be automatically upgraded. But once Synchrony makes their decision based on your credit history and your credit score, then you will be automatically upgraded to the unsecured credit card. And at the time that they upgrade you to the unsecured credit card with Amazon, they will provide you with a refund of the deposit that you provided when you first opened that secured credit card account. All right, so let's talk about the good, the bad, and the ugly of this specific card and then secured cards in general. So I'll use an example of someone that they're offered a $1,000 credit limit with their secured card. That means you'd have to provide $1,000 to Amazon, at least $1,000, or you can choose a lower amount. Like if you only want to do $500, then you can deposit just $500. But the maximum you'll be able to do is $1,000. So if you decide that, okay, well, they gave me a $1,000 limit, but I'd like it to be $2,000, it doesn't mean that you can just provide them with $2,000 cash as a deposit. The max that they will give you is what your credit limit is approved by Synchrony, who is the decision maker in your credit limit. So the good news is if you've had bad credit in the past, or if you don't have any credit, this is a good way to get started with improving your credit score, or to improve your credit score if you've had bad credit in the past and you can't get an unsecured card from another company or through Amazon specifically. Now, the bad news is that because it is a secured card, you have to come up with the deposit to match the credit limit that you want and that they have approved for you. So if they approve $1,000, you have to provide $1,000 cash, which you then deposit to Synchrony, and that is used as collateral in case you don't pay back the items that you purchase on your credit card. Now, those deposits cannot be used as payments. You still use it the same way you would use an unsecured card. That deposit is just in case you don't pay it in the future, and once they close your card because you haven't made payments, they can use that deposit as collateral to pay those debts, and they don't lose out on any money. Whereas with an unsecured card, if you don't pay it back, then they have to go through the collection process, to go through the credit bureaus, and then put those negative marks on your credit card. And then that way, maybe you'll pay it because you want to remove those marks. But usually the initial provider of that credit usually loses the business, and they end up selling off that debt to credit agencies, who then, those are the people who actually go after you and call you and harass you to make sure you pay those debts, because they bought those debts at pennies on the dollar, and then anything that they're able to make from it, it's a great profit for them. Now, another bad thing about having to make that $1,000 deposit for your secured credit card is that $1,000 could have been in a savings account gaining interest instead of potentially paying interest on the future products that you're going to buy with that deposit for the secured credit card. And you don't actually get to use that cash. That cash is just sitting. So instead of you making upwards of 2% in a savings account, the bank is actually making money off of your money while it sits in that account as the collateral for your credit card. And not only 2%, but you could be investing that $1,000 in the stock market, where the average gain over the past 30 years has been over 8% in the market. So it's not really a great idea. If you can find a way to get an unsecured credit card to build your credit, that's actually a better option than having that secured card. But if that's your only option, then maybe a secured card may be right for you. And I'll make another video going into more details about secured credit cards that's not specifically about this Amazon card. So not ugly about this specific card. The interest rate for this card is 28%. Now, that is really high. And of course, you're getting a bad interest rate because you have bad credit, or you don't have any credit, so they don't have any history to show that you are trustworthy with your payments. So you could have been paying rent or maybe paying a cell phone bill, things that aren't reported on your credit report for the past 10, 20, 30 years. But if you never had a credit card, they will treat you the same way they would someone that has, like, that's 18, just got out of high school, just started working. They don't have any credit history or any rent payment history or your cell phone or anything like that. So they're going to treat you just like that because you don't have the credit history to go off to show that you're a trustworthy steward of your credit card. So another bad thing about this card is that now you have access to the millions of products that Amazon sells. So if you had bad credit in the past, typically it's because of bad spending habits, or it could also be because you lost a job and weren't able to pay the credit card bills that you had. So now you have access to Amazon, where you can purchase things for money that you technically don't have, because even though you're depositing that $1,000 into the account, it's not the actual money that you're spending. You still have to come up with the $100 or $200 or whatever you end up spending on that credit card to pay off the bill in the next month, so that you don't get charged interest on the items that you purchase. So if you haven't already changed your spending habits, that's just going to put you further into debt with that very high interest rate for this card. So you definitely want to make sure that you're paying that off every month, and you're not allowing any more interest to gain, and you're not allowing those bad habits that you had in the past because of your bad credit. Or, you know, if you lost your job, you were spending too much because you weren't able to pay that with any of the savings that you had. So if you check out some of my past videos, I talk about saving, I talk about investing. Make sure you check those videos out as well. And I'll make a video soon to talk about just credit cards in general, and specifically secured credit cards. All right, thanks for taking the time to watch this video. Got a little bit of different scenery today. I'm in Georgia on a short little vacation. I'll post a little video that I made where actually there are about 20 ducks that came up while I was sitting on this bench next to the lake. They're probably looking for bread. I didn't bring any bread for them or any type of food, so now they've gone away. But again, thanks for watching this video. If you're not a current subscriber, make sure you hit that subscribe button down below. Hit that like button because you really like this video. And make sure you hit that notification bell so you'll be notified the next time I create a video. Again, thanks for watching. You guys have a great day. Thanks.
We'll be right back.